Hello and welcome to video 14 of the Articy Draft First Steps tutorial series. In the last video, we visited the document view. We saw how documents are structured in Articy and wrote a linear cutscene for our project that we then converted to connected nodes in the flow. In this lesson, we will revisit the flow view and go through the final confrontation dialog step by step. We create reaction points and choice points by adding scripting logic and learn about another way to use conditions and instructions. Start by submerging into the Final Confrontation dialog node in the tutorial folder of the flow. First thing you will notice from the underscore F addition to the name is that the Mina entity is from the final version. This is because this dialog existed before we even created the Mina entity in the tutorial folder. To preserve the project's continuity, we should update the entity so that we use the same entity for the entire tutorial part of the project. We can do this by double-clicking the speaker name to highlight it and then starting to type the name. The selection drop-down opens and we can choose the proper entity. With that out of the way, let's take a closer look at the dialogue in detail. Right at the beginning, we want to have a reaction point. If we zoom in closer on the condition node, we see some text in there stating that we want to pick up on the fact again if Dracula knows Mina's name or not. If we want to use text within a condition or instruction, for example to use it as a placeholder for the scripting expression, it needs to be in the form of a comment. To create a single-line comment, just start the sentence with double forward slashes. If you don't do this, Articy tries to interpret it as an expression, which will result in an error. In this condition, we need to check the state of the name revealed variable. The variable value might have changed in the first dialogue, depending on which choice the player made. Global variables cannot just be used within one layer of the flow, but throughout the entire project. Do you still remember what the structure of a condition looks like? If you want to test yourself, you can pause the video, enter your solution, and then continue with the video to compare. The basic structure of a condition is variable set name dot variable name, operator, value. If you are unsure about a name or want to check to which set a variable belongs, just click the Global Variable System folder in the navigator. Here we can see all information. We need the Name Revealed variable from the Dialogue Chapter 1 variable set. As soon as you start typing the set name inside the condition node, autocomplete kicks in and you can use Enter or Tab to complete. Next comes the variable name, separated by a dot. As we only have one variable in this set so far, the name is displayed in the selection drop-down right after typing the dot. Again, complete by pressing Enter or Tab. Next is the operator. We want to check for a specific value, therefore we use the relational operator double equal sign. The variable was created with a default value of false. It gets set to true within the first dialogue, if Dracula finds out Mina's name. We will check for the true state. So our complete expression will read Dialogue Chapter 1 dot name revealed double equal sign true. If the entire expression is true, which happens in the case the variable value is true, the conversation will continue through the green output pin. If Dracula did not find out Mina's name back in the first dialogue, the flow will continue through the red pin. After the reaction point, the dialogue merges down to one branch again. Shortly after, we arrive at a point that looks a bit busier. We have four outgoing connections from this node, and two connections that point to the input pin from positions further down the flow. The outgoing connections mark another choice point for the player. There is a difference to the choice point in the first dialogue, however. Not all choice options are always available. If you look closer at the input pins of the choices, you can see that the first two are highlighted in orange. That means that these pins hold additional information, in this case, conditions. Sometimes it is not possible to use a condition node, for example, in a case like this, where more than two options are available. To be able to have some of the choices only appear when certain circumstances are met, we can put conditions into input pins. If you hover over a pin, its content is displayed in a small pop-up. Double-click the input pin to open its edit window. We have another comment here telling us what we are supposed to do here. This dialog option should only be visible to the player if Mina has the stake item in her inventory. In video 11, we created the stake item and also a new variable set representing Mina's inventory. Can you guess what the condition needs to look like? It is very similar to the one before. We check for the value of a variable. Only this time we are dealing with a different variable set. Inventory.stake double equal sign true. That is our expression here. If Mina did at any point of the story pick up the stake, then the variable value will be true. Which means the entire expression returns true as well. That means the dialog option is available for the player. If Mina did not receive the item yet, which is currently the case in our project, the expression will be false, and this dialog option will be hidden from the player. If this option is available to the player and gets chosen, the dialogue ends immediately, and a fight between Mina and Dracula starts that concludes this first chapter of the story. It is symbolized by a placeholder node in Articy, as the actual combat mechanics would be realized in the game engine. Open the input pin of the second choice now and look at the comment. Here we are supposed to add another condition, so that this dialog option is also only visible if the condition is met. This option is only supposed to appear after the player asked at least one other question. Okay, how can we realize this? Any ideas? There is no new functionality involved. We can do it with the tools we have seen so far. Let's look at it step by step. From the conditions we worked with earlier today, we learned that if a condition inside an input pin returns false for the overall expression, the flow does not continue through this node. In case of our choice point, it means that this particular option is not displayed to the player. That means we want to phrase the condition in a way that the first time the player arrives at this choice point, the expression returns a false value for this option. But before we can check for anything, we need to create a variable for this situation. Click the entry Dialogue Chapter 1 beneath Global Variables in the Navigator to go directly to this variable set. Now create a new variable by clicking the Create Variable button in the toolbar. I'll call it First Question and enter a short description. Boolean as a default type is correct. But I will change the default value to true. I tend to choose the starting value in a way that phrasing scripting expressions make the most logical sense for me. You will be able to see my train of thought in a minute when we get to write the scripting expressions. This is the only variable we need, so we can go back to the dialog now. Open the edit window again by double-clicking the node's input pin. The first part of the expression should be pretty easy. Variable set name dot variable name relational operator. Dialogue chapter 1 dot first question double equal sign. But what do we check for now? Remember, the starting value for the variable is true. Is this the first question? Yes. But we only want this option to appear if the player asked another question first. So we need to check for a false value here. Great. First step taken. Now we only need a way to change the value of the variable. This we will be doing with the last two choices. There you can see that the output pins are highlighted in orange. That means that now we are dealing with instructions. Conditions always go into the input pin, as something is checked to determine if the node will even be accessible. And instructions are placed in the output pin, to change some value or state after going through this node. You will also see what kind of content is expected as a prompt inside the pin's edit window. The last two dialog options are always available to the player, so this is where we will put in our instructions. The first option could be visible if Mina has the stake, but as this option ends the dialog right away, we don't need to add an instruction here. Open the output pin by double-clicking. We now need to change the variable value. After going through the node, we are no longer at the point of the first question, as we have just asked it. So we need to change the variable value to false. Dialog chapter 1.firstQuestion equal sign false. We can now copy this expression to the remaining node. If the player chooses either of the last two options, they get a response from Dracula, and then the flow goes back to the line where Dracula asks what we want to know. Let's take a quick look at how this plays out. Select the Dracula node before the choice point and start a presentation. If we are in analysis mode, we see that only two of the options are valid responses. The conditions for the other two are not met. This is why they are highlighted in red. They would not be shown to the player. If we continue this conversation, the value for the first question variable gets changed, which results in another option being available when we get to the choice point again. We can now choose the response that takes us out of the question loop and continues with the final battle. Very nice. In today's lesson, we have learned that instructions and conditions can be put into node pins, and we improved the dialogue by adding some interactivity through scripting. In the next video, we will continue working with this dialogue and update its structure with hub and jump flow elements. Thank you for joining us, and join us again in our next tutorial.